What did you do, Nico? This is the goodbye.
So, we left Cairns 4 hours ago, drove straight up to the Wallaman Falls. The guys flew back to Sydney this morning, and we back with the three of us on the road for probably the last week, because we all running out of money, and yeah, we're driving back south. Everyone is a bit fucked from the weekend. We did a lot of partying, but we're now back on the road. We're going south and we're gonna end the trip very soon. But first, enjoy the lovely pieces we missed on the way up, whatever. I don't know what I'm gonna say. Doesn't make sense at all. I think I'm probably fucked. Anyway, I'm gonna put it in the videos, whatever. Nico, you wanna say some bullshit as well?
I want to.
Eric wants to say some bullshit. Oh no, that's like the level from now on.
Yeah, like, we're like really good at this moment. We're still going on, we're still going strong.
Yeah.
And we're in some waterfalls doing some random bullshit, and yeah, I like my life right now.
Yeah, good story. Yeah,
that's a good story.
As you can see, we were pretty hangover from all the parties that week. Anyway, we are now at the Wallaman Falls in Queensland, which is Australia's tallest permanent waterfall with a plunge of nearly 300 meters. Unfortunately, it is a very dry period, so there's not much water to fall down. However, the drive up was amazing, and it's quite impressive how quickly the landscape changes. Do you remember this place from a previous episode? It's Yarrawonga Notch, and it's definitely one of our favorite camp spots in Queensland. Maybe even in whole Australia. Look how beautiful this is. And the best thing is, it's all for free. Oh yeah, that's what I tried to explain here, but yeah, as you know, I lost all the audio footage. Anyway, look at this.
What did you do, Nico?
Slow down.
Okay.
How long are you in Australia for?
6 months.
For 6 months. Yeah. So, how long have you been here now?
Here now? You mean in Australia or in Queensland?
In Australia.
6 months. Yeah, the same.
So when are you leaving?
Next April.
Okay. Mate, it's very dangerous speeding at your speed. It's $435. Okay. So you do have payment options explained here, so you can do it on the internet, by mail.
Do you know if I can pay monthly?
Yes. Or you should be able to. There's a number you can call for voluntary installment plan. Okay, but there's information there you can go by. All right. In the meanwhile, stick to the speed limit and be careful, eh?
Okay.
All right. Drop safe.
Yep.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
So today's Eric's birthday. Happy Woo! Birthday!
Thanks.
And we drove, that's basically why we drove all the way to Noosa in the last 3 days. So we left Cairns 3 days ago, and that's about, I think, 1,800 kilometers from here. Maybe a little bit less, but it's quite a distance we drove in the past 2 days. 3 days. And so we are in Noosa now. We have been here before, but we didn't have time to explore it like properly, and that's what we're gonna do today. So we are in the national park, and Eric really wants to surf, so hopefully we'll catch some waves, and yeah, I'm gonna make some nice shots, of course. Today we arrived in Brisbane, and we're gonna visit my old boss. She invited us in her new home. She just moved from Sydney to Brisbane, and she said, "Brom, if you're done with camping and you wanna have some luxury and you have a nice bed, come to my house. You know, you can watch a movie, jump in the pool, I make you some dinner." So that's very nice. Thanks for that, Sarah. And we're staying in this lovely house for today. Nice. Well, after a couple of weeks in the tent, this is quite a good place to camp in the cinema.
Perfect.
That's what I thought.
That's really good.
Before we leave Brizzy, we wanted to visit the lagoon. It's a free swimming pool in the middle of the city. How nice is that?
So we visited Brisbane today and the Gold Coast. It was both really, really nice, but we didn't feel like going into the city or spending a lot of time over there. The thing is, I think with Surfers Paradise and Gold Coast, you really, really have to take your time. Let's say go there for a week, and then, yeah, you know, you can have like the real experience. Besides that, it's almost Monday again, and next Monday we're gonna go back to work. So we're driving back to Sydney. I think we will be there the day after tomorrow. We've been away for 6 weeks and it's been so good. Now we're just camping in a really nice spot. I think you hear the river on that side and you hear the music on that side. I'm gonna show you this place tomorrow with daylight. And tomorrow we drive to Newcastle, which is gonna be a 7-hour drive. And then we are only 2 hours left from Collingwood, which yeah, I think that is gonna bring us back the day after tomorrow. For now, we're just enjoying our last, or maybe the pre-last grill night with amazing chef cook Nico, and yeah, that's it.
So basically what we did the whole East Coast, we had a lot of party with music, we had a lot of barbecue like we're doing right now, and of course we had like a lot of beers. But now it's like almost empty on the table, but it's on trash can because we're good people. And yeah, it was fucking great. And I love it. It's perfect.
So this is the place where we camped last night. How peaceful. And the perfect place for a skinny dip, isn't it, Nico? All good things come to an end, and nothing is forever, which is probably a good thing. But things like this don't have to end for me at all. However, the reality is that we are on our way through its beautiful scenery to the final destination of our East Coast journey, Newcastle. We were on the road for 6 weeks and drove over 7,000 kilometers without a flat tire. We camped in beautiful places, went to a great festival, met new people and created many valuable memories. Guys, a huge shout out to you, Eric and Nico. What a great guys you are and what a great team we have been. We slept in that little tent with the three of us for 6 weeks and I'm really going to miss you in my bed. And what about all the grill nights? Nico, huge compliments for your cooking skills. Although a steak needs to be eaten medium rare, in my opinion.
Got a ticket to a better day, in and go, don't even try. But you won't even have to run away, still you're gonna feel alive. I can show you an easy way, just take my hand to mine. When you feel like we're standing still, it's gonna catch you by surprise. We pay, we win, and stop.
Anyway, this is going to be the end of the season. I will have new episodes coming about Bali and New Zealand because Australia is coming to an end. Thanks for watching and see you soon.